Hey guys, Mike Acosta here from ADSR, and in this video, I'll be covering the top 5 things that we like about the UNO Synth from IK Multimedia. Now, this little synth comes in at under $200 and has some seriously cool functions under its hood, and most importantly, sounds really good for the price. Now, the UNO Synth does have a 100% analog signal path, but does have the modern digital conveniences that we've all come to love and expect from most modern synthesizers. So let's jump right into our first feature that we really enjoy with the UNO Synth. Also, make sure that you're listening to this demo on a pair of really good studio monitors or a set of really good over-the-ear headphones, as listening on your mobile device's built-in speaker or laptop speakers won't really translate as well. So again, just make sure you're listening on a really good set of like studio monitors or a really good pair of headphones. All right, so the first thing that we really enjoy about the UNO Synth is the software editor. And it runs completely standalone if you want, but there's also a VST plugin version of the software editor, which can run in all major DAWs on both Mac and Windows. And there is also an editor for iOS, which means that you can run the UNO Synth editor on your iPhone or on your iPad. Now, the editor allows for really easy access to much deeper hidden functions of the UNO for programming. So this is really great for sound designing. This means that you can create patches much quicker, along with an easier method for saving your patches to a specific location. I also really enjoyed using the editor because the interface is completely resizable. That means that I can just grab right down here in the bottom right corner. Let's just drag this out, and we can make it much larger. So this is great if you're working on a really large display, or we can shrink it back down. Either way, it is adjustable to whatever suits your workflow best. And as I mentioned earlier, the editor is also available for Apple's iOS, which means that it can run on an iPhone or an iPad for mobile programmability. So this is great if you just want to head out somewhere and work on some patches. The fact that the UNO is battery powered, and of course iPad is battery powered, all you need is one simple connection, which is, you know, a lightning to USB cable, and you're good to go. And now this leads me to our next favorite feature. And that is that the UNO Synth is battery powered. It's a big thing now with a lot of really small synthesizers and drum machines being able to be battery powered, because this, of course, means that it's super, super portable. You can use it everywhere. And the UNO has a capacitive sensing keyboard. So there's no need to carry a MIDI keyboard when you're sound designing. So again, when I was talking about, you know, having the editor on an iPhone or an iPad, the fact that the UNO has a capacitive sensing keyboard on it means you don't really need to have some sort of additional MIDI keyboard connected. Again, super, super portable and easy to sound design with. The UNO Synth also functions as a MIDI controller within your DAW to control other VSTs or create custom mappings of the knobs. Again, this is all part of it being, you know, portable and battery powered. The other thing too is that it is really great for live performances. When used in conjunction with live performance-based apps such as Apple's Main Stage or something like Akai's VIP 3.0. Now, our next favorite feature on the UNO Synth are the continuous wave-shaping oscillators. Essentially, you can go from a triangle to a saw and then to a square in the first half of the knob travel. Then you have variable pulse width of the square wave in the second half of the knob travel. So let's check out how that sounds as we sweep through the different wave shapes, and you'll hear the slight variations that start to happen as it morphs from one shape to another. Thank you. Now, the other thing that I found really cool with the oscillators is that you can also automate some mild morphing between the wave shapes within your sequence, especially within Ableton Live by using something like Max for Live LFO. This allows me to assign each of the wave shaping knobs to the Max for Live LFO, and I can then automate some things in real time and have it morphing in between these different wave shapes as the sequence plays. This allows me to get some very unique kind of sounds and things, and it's never going to sound exactly the same as it's always morphing back and forth. So just something I thought was really cool. Now, favorite thing number four that we enjoy about the UNO Synth is its filter. It is a two-pole, OTA-based, analog resonant, sweepable multimode filter. And that's really cool because you basically get low pass, high pass, or band pass within this filter. And again, it is a 100% analog signal path, so it sounds really good. You can get a vintage or even a modern sound, depending on how you're adjusting the resonance and the overdrive. Now, the reason for this is that the resonance and the overdrive both interact with each other in a really interesting way that lets you dial in more vintage sounding tones to, of course, a more modern aggressive sound. The reason is that the resonant control boosts a resonant peak at the filter cutoff. This hits the overdrive a lot harder and therefore adds more odd harmonics to the sound. So the result is much more aggressive and modern sounding when you use it this way. Now, last but not least, our final feature that we really enjoy on the UNO Synth is its built-in 16-step sequencer. Now, the 16-step sequencer has a couple of different record modes. And the first one, obviously, it has real-time recording, which is great. Now, if you're rhythmically challenged and not very good at playing things in real time, then of course you have the step record mode. And this allows you to manually enter the note assignment for each step within that sequence. Now, you also have the ability to record parameter changes in real time on a per step basis. Now, this is really similar to Electron's parameter locks and another feature that's also on Roland's TR-8S sequencer. It's really, really fun to do. So I'm glad that they have this kind of feature again on a very small synth under $200. So let me show you really quick on how this works. Essentially, I'm gonna take the filter and on every single step within this sequence, I'm going to place the filter at a different setting. And as this plays back, you'll hear exactly what this sounds like. It's very different than simply grabbing the knob and turning it all crazy in real time. It's very different. And remember, you can do this with other things besides the filter. And that's what makes this function really nice. Now, the step sequencer also runs in three different directions. It can run forward, run the sequence backwards, and it can also do forward and backward. You can also change the length of your sequences between 1 and 16 steps. All right, so these are just five things about the UNO Synth that we personally enjoyed here at ADSR. There are a ton of other features that are all packed in this little box, and for coming in under $200, you really can't go wrong. Portability, battery-powered or USB bus-powered, MIDI over USB along with DIN connection cables for hardware MIDI, 100% analog signal path, built-in effects, and actually sounds good. It's almost a no-brainer, especially for live rigs where space is an issue. If you want more information, make sure you head on over to IK Multimedia site where they have a ton of instructional videos on the UNO Synth itself. Also, make sure you hit the subscribe button below to stay up to date with everything and anything ADSR. My name is Mike Acosta, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.